Hi, praise the Lord. God bless you. My name is Bishop Bob Jackson. I'm the pastor of Axeville Gospel Church, and I want to welcome you to the Axeville Gospel Church broadcast. Don't you touch that dial, because I believe God has a word for you today. And listen, I'm telling you, God is blessing His people like never before, but we've got to get into the Word of God. So get your Bibles. Come on, get your Bibles, get your family, call your friends and tell them, listen, Axeville Gospel Church is on the air and we want to make sure we get everything that God is saying to us on today.
Through the storm, God has delivered you. He's done what no one else could do. Time after time, He's made a way. You abundantly, still you sit in church so quietly. But how can you sit there with nothing to say when you know the Lord has made a way?
Oh my Lord,
can I get a witness?
Oh my Lord,
will you be a witness?
Oh my Lord,
oh will you be a witness?
Oh my Lord,
holy Ghost witness.
Oh my Lord,
a sanctified witness.
Oh my Lord,
a true born.
For my Lord,
for my Lord, heartaches and pain,
I'll be a witness.
Through sickness and rain,
I'll be a witness.
Through ups and downs,
I'll be a witness.
Scattered all around
generations. So we worship you, we glorify you, and we lift up your name today, because there's nobody like you. Come on, worshipers, let's worship the Lord. Come on, let's clap our hands in the sanctuary and begin to bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, you're so good. We love you today. Come on, let's say it. Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Come on, help us say it. Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Lord, you're so good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
People
from every nation and tongue,
from generation.
So
what are we going to do? We worship.
We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And He's worthy to be praised.
Yes, yes, yes.
So come on, let's give Him our worship.
Hallelujah.
Let's give Him our praise. Hallelujah. One more time. Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
You didn't have to do it, but you did.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy
Hallelujah.
Endureth forever.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth.
You've been so good to me, Lord.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Oh, people
from every nation, and
from generation,
to generation.
So we worship.
We worship you.
We sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We worship.
We worship
just
you.
Because of who. You've been so good to me, Lord. Hallelujah. We sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We worship.
Yeah. Just be who you are. You are good.
Hallelujah. Oh, taste and see. that the Lord is good. Come on, anybody know he's good today? Hallelujah. Oh, you are good
all the time. All the time. You are good.
You are good.
You are good.
All the time.
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 You are good.
You are good.
You are good.
So good.
All the time.
You're so good.
You are good.
Yeah, yeah.
You are good.
You're so good.
All the time.
All the time.
All the time.
You woke me up this morning. Started me on
all
my way. You've been good
all
to me.
The time.
Put clothes on
you
my back.
Good.
You put shoes
you
on my feet.
Good.
Food on
all
my table. So good.
All the time.
So good.
You are good.
Everybody give him praise. We worship you. Lord, we worship you. If I had 10,000 tongues, I could not praise you enough. I could not worship you enough. Because you've been so good. So good to me, Lord. Yeah. You're so good. Yeah, one more time. You are
good.
Worship you, Lord. All the time. You're so good.
All the time.
All the time.
You're so good.
You're so good.
You are good.
Yeah.
All the time.
All the time. Yeah.
So
we worship you.
We worship you.
We sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
We worship. So good. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of glory. He's worthy of honor. So we lift our hands in worship. We lift our hands in worship to you. We lift our hands in worship. We worship you, Lord. We glorify you, Lord. You're so good. You're so good. You're so good, Jesus. You're so good.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Come on, can somebody just lift up your hands?
Thank you.
And just worship the Lord because he's been just that good. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. If I had 10,000 tongues, if I had 10,000 hands, I couldn't thank him enough. I couldn't show enough gratitude, enough appreciation for how good you are, God. Thank you. So I just have to lift up a hallelujah
to the Lord. Come on, it's the high praise. Anybody got a hallelujah in this house today? My hallelujah belongs to you. Because you alone deserve the praise. You alone deserve the glory and the honor. My hallelujah belongs to you. Come on, you know it. My hallelujah belongs to you. Nobody else gets it, Lord. My hallelujah belongs to you. Yes. My hallelujah, it belongs to you. And here's the reason. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. Yeah. You deserve it. Help me say my hallelujah.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, lift your voice and just tell him my hallelujah.
My hallelujah, it belongs to you.
Oh, for all of the things that you've done.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Only you, Lord.
My hallelujah belongs to you.
Now come on, lift it up. You deserve it.
You deserve it.
Take the credit, cause I couldn't do it by myself.
All of the glory, it belongs to you.
Come on, point your worship up to the King of Kings. All of the
all
glory,
of the glory,
nobody but you, Lord.
To you.
Oh,
all of the glory,
it belongs to you. Now open your mouth real big and say, you deserve it.
You deserve it.
Only you, Lord.
You deserve it.
Only you, Lord.
You deserve it.
You alone deserve it.
You deserve it.
When I think of all that you've done,
you deserve it.
All the ways that you've made,
you deserve it.
Every door that Thank you, Jesus. It all belongs to you, Savior, my King. Yes, my thank you, Jesus. It belongs to you. Just one more time. You deserve it, because you deserve it. You deserve it. Can you help me say you? If you know he deserves it.
You deserve it.
And come on, as I take my seat while we're right there, can we just give him praise? Can you help me sing that praise?
saints go up in praise. That's when the Spirit shall inhabit this place. When the saints get on one accord and begin to bless the Lord, then the King
Praise the Lord, saints. This is Elder Joseph Cotton Jr. from Asheville Gospel Church, where Jesus Christ is Lord. I want to thank God that you tuned in to watch us this morning, this Sunday morning, to give God all the praise and all the glory as we have moved back to live stream, amen, but it's only temporary, amen. But I want to thank God for you tuning in to hear what saith the Lord, and we give God all the praise and the glory, and we thank you for supporting Asheville Gospel Church throughout the many years, amen. It's going on 38 years for Asheville Gospel Church serving the community in Oakland, California, amen. And I want to give a big shout out to our pastor, Bishop Bob Jackson, amen. He just celebrated 76 years, amen. His birthday was December 31st, and we just thank the Lord Jesus Christ for him and blessing us with his leadership, his wisdom, his understanding, amen. And we thank God for his wife, amen. We thank God for his wife, Lady Barbara Jackson. God bless you both, amen, as you get you some rest, some well-deserved rest, amen, because even through the pandemic, we have been serving faithfully and being a blessing to our community, and we want to thank God for all of you that have supported us throughout the years, amen. But I want to get into the Word of God today. I want you to turn to 2 Corinthians chapter 7, 2 Corinthians chapter 7, and we're going to pick it up at verse 12. Once again, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, and we're going to pick it up at verse 12. I was praying as I was preparing for a message today and what to speak, and I reflected on the past couple of years of dealing with the pandemic. And so many people have died, and so many people are getting sick. And I'm saying, Lord, what are we supposed to do dealing with things like this? And he brought back to my remembrance the children of Israel. The children of Israel was in slavery and bondage for 400 years. And there was a time when God heard their prayer, and he sent Moses to deliver them from the hands of the enemy. He sent Moses to deliver them. They came out of Egypt, but yet they was on their way to the promised land. Now, when you do the research, the promised land was an 11-day journey from Egypt. Once again, from Egypt to the promised land was an 11-day journey. So they would have reached the promised land in 11 days. But they end up wandering in the wilderness for 40 years. Now, how did 11 days turn into 40 years? Because people started complaining. Unbelief crept in to the people. People start complaining. They start operating in unbelief. They start rejecting God, and they just start just not doing the things that they should have did. And I say it's a lot like today. People have drifted away from God and start doing the things they want to do. People have no reverence and no respect for God at all. Right now we have people, we have children, young children, killing each other, shoot them up, bang, bang. We have people in sexual sins, people doing what they want to do, but yet they say they love God, but there's no evidence that they love God. We have people that's in the body of Christ that's negative all the time. We have people that just operate in unbelief. And God is not happy with his people. And just like in the old times with the children of Israel, this generation is dying day by day before God's people inherit the promised land. Let me say that again. This generation that is operating in unbelief, doing what they want to do with no respect for God, have left God, doing whatever they want to do, whatever wickedness or whatever thought, whatever thing come to their mind, they are doing it and saying it's all right and I don't care, like there's no consequences. I want you to know that there is a heaven and there is a hell, and one day we are going to be judged. And if you don't have Jesus a part of your life, you're going to go downstairs instead of going upstairs. You can believe that, because that's a fact. Amen. We are going to have to answer to God one day when our time in this world is over. But right now, God is trying to draw his people back to him, trying to draw his people back to a relationship with God so that he can give his people some instructions. So the children of Israel wandered in the wilderness for 40 years because of their disobedience, because of their unbelief. And I believe that the coronavirus is here to draw people back to God. Because sometimes people don't turn away from their sins until all hell has broken out. And I want you to understand that right now, people, saints, people that don't believe, because it rained on the just and the unjust. So we all been affected by this season dealing with the coronavirus. But I believe that God has shown me that this too shall come to pass. But right now, God is trying to get the attention of this world to turn back to him and to turn from their wicked ways. But when will the people really turn from their wicked ways? Because sin is destroying people. Sin, disobedient to God, is killing people. Because the enemy job is to steal, kill, and to destroy. But Jesus said, I come that you might have life and might have it more abundantly. God wants you to inherit the promised land, but the devil wants you to die in this land. This land that we're living in now is symbolic of Egypt, where wickedness, sin, sexual sin, disobedience to God, poverty, some people have it and some people don't. We have homelessness. We have heartbreaks and marriages can't stay together. We don't have fathers in the homes no more. We got women trying to mother the children and take care of the children, trying to work and feed the kids. And the man want to walk around and try to be a pimp and trying to be a player. We got Pentecostal players at the church. We got wickedness. We got hope mongering and things. It's in the church and outside of the church. The world is trying to infiltrate the church. And right now, God is not happy with it at all. And God wants his people to turn from their wicked ways and to repent and to come back to him. So if you look at 2 Chronicles chapter 7, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, watch this. It says this in verse 12. In verse 12, it says, and the Lord appeared to Solomon by night, and said unto him, I have heard the prayer, and I've chosen this place to myself for a house of sacrifice. Talking about the house of the Lord. If I shut up heaven that there be no rain, or if I command the locusts to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if, that's a big word, if my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and forgive their sin and will heal their land. Now my eyes shall be open and my ears attend unto the prayer that is made in this place. Let me read that same verses in the NLT version, the New Living Translation. Amen. You might not have this, but listen to it. Watch this. This is the New Living Translation, the NLT version, 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 12. And it says, then one night the Lord appeared to Solomon and said, I have heard your prayer, and I've chosen this temple as the place for making sacrifices. At times, I might shut up the heavens so that no rain falls, or command grasshoppers to devour the crops, or send plagues among you. Then if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways. Do what? Turn from their wicked ways. I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sins and restore their land. My eyes will be open and my ears attentive to every prayer made in this place. This is the call for God's chosen people, God's church, to turn from their wicked ways. Because the church is not the church that the Lord Jesus Christ designed it to be. We are supposed to be the light of the world. We are supposed to be a city that's set on a hill that you cannot hide. We are supposed to infiltrate the unbelieving world, to penetrate, to infiltrate, and to get them to see for them to be able to see what we see and to be able to infiltrate and take over the city and turn them to God. But the church have become more like the world every day, and God is not having it. And now we have a plague that's on this planet. It's not just in one city, it's in the whole world, and God is trying to get the world to turn from their wicked ways. But people are still choosing to do what they want to do instead of humbling themselves and coming back to God and to repent of their sins. The church is trying to get more members by trying to be more like the world instead of being more like Jesus. And God is not having that. So why I'm praying, I'm asking God, why and when? Why? It's because of sin that we still dealing with the coronavirus these past couple years. Because sin have taken over this world. It's on the internet. It's on the TV. It's ungodly in all kind of ways. On your phone, you can see things have penetrated and infiltrated our lives and have drawn us away from God instead of drawing us to God. When God created these things, this because the devil can't create nothing. He only can pervert what God created. Let me say that again. The devil cannot create anything. He only can pervert what God has created. So the cell phones, the computers, the things, the technology that God has blessed man to be able to create, God is the one that give man the knowledge and give man the ideas of witty inventions. But man have turned and used it to glorify the devil to get more likes and to get more views instead of lifting up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because the Lord wants us to be able to lift him up. And he said, and if I be lifted up, I would draw all men unto me. But this world have lost its ways. This world have become more like the devil than it is God. And how do God get his children to turn away from their sins? He allows something like the virus to take place. So the question is it the devil that's killing the people or God? Is it the devil killing people or God? Because God allowing this to happen for a season. But don't mean that God don't see what's going on. Don't mean that God don't hear our prayers. But God want to have his children and his people to turn from their wicked ways and to acknowledge that they are wrong and that they need to turn back to the Lord Jesus Christ, to turn from their wicked ways. Then he said, I will heal their land and forgive them of their sins. But our people have lived this life without God, with no fear of God, not understanding that one day you're going to have to give an answer. You're going to have to stand before God and you're going to have to give an answer on why you did what you did. Why did you live your life without acknowledging him? Why did you live your life in sin? Because the judgment going to come. And I believe that the virus is here to turn the people back to God. If you look at the Old Testament, when the people have drifted away from God, death entered in. God allowed pestilence and things to happen to get people's attention for them to repent of their sins. I believe right now today that God is still doing the same thing. He have allowed the coronavirus to come into this world for man to repent of their sins and to turn from their wicked ways. But right now, man is still trying to operate with his own wisdom, with his own understanding. Instead of trusting in the Lord and leaning out to their own understanding, man have chose to lean to his own understanding. But this is the time that we have to humble ourselves in the presence of Almighty God and to ask God to help us and to direct us, because people are dying every day. People are dying and people are crying out from help from the Lord. I believe the year 2022 is going to be an unusual year that the Lord is going to manifest himself in ways like the old days. We're going to see signs. We're going to see wonders. We're going to see miracles that's going to happen that people will not be able to doubt or be able to try to remove and say it was God. It's going to be undeniable miracles that's going to take place, and men are going to have to repent from their sins and turn back to God. Because right now, death and destruction is all over the planet. And God is going to reveal himself in a mighty way. But we have to humble ourselves right now. We have to humble ourselves in the presence of God. And we need to turn from our wicked ways. We need to repent of our sins and acknowledge that we are wrong and God is right. We have to ask God for instructions. We need to ask God for guidance. And if we have to put the blood over our doorposts to make sure that death come not towards our house, that's what we have to do. But at the end of the day, this season will not be over until this world repent of their sins and to turn from their wicked ways. And the first thing they need to do is to humble themselves. People need to humble themselves in the sight of God. Repent of your sins. Ask God for forgiveness. And he will forgive you. No matter what you have done, God will forgive you, because he sent his son, the Lord Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for all of our sins. And his blood is what washes us. His blood, Jesus, the Lord Jesus' blood is what washes away all of our sins and make us in right standing in the sight of God. The blood of Jesus. So we got to turn from our wicked ways, repent of our sins, humble ourselves, and ask God to lead us and guide us and tell us what we need to do to come out of this season. My people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray. Are people praying enough today? Do you believe that prayer work? Or are you just getting up because you're so busy, you run out of time to pray to God? Or we do a microwave prayer. Lord, thank you for blessing me with another day. I thank you, Heavenly Father, for protecting my children. I thank you, Lord, for blessing me, Lord. I thank you right now for blessing me with a job. I thank you for the food on my table. Amen. And you go on about your day. Don't you know God want to have a bigger relationship with you than that? God want to have an intimate, a personal relationship with you, my brothers, my sisters. God want to be a part of every part of your life. How do we see a better life for ourselves? We have to see what God see. We have to say what God say. We have to see things like God sees it. We have to start trusting in the Lord with all our heart and lean not to our own understanding, but in all our ways acknowledge him, and he shall direct our path. He said, be not wise in our own eyes, but fear the Lord, depart from evil, do good. So shall it be health to thy navel and marrow to thy bones. We got to humble ourselves. Every day I try to humble myself in the presence of God. because I know I need him to direct my path. I need his knowledge, his wisdom, his understanding. And the only way I can get that is to pray and pray and pray until God give me the instructions that I need. But we need to humble ourselves and pray and seek his face. We got to seek the Lord while he can be found. We have to seek the Lord. How do you seek the Lord? You got to pick up the Bible. You got to get in this book. You got to get in the Word of God. You need to read some scriptures. You need to meditate. Matter of fact, you need to eat the Word every day. You need to eat the Word every day. Get it into your spirit. Amen. The more you seek God by praying, by reading His Word, by studying His Word, the more God will reveal Himself to you. The closer you get to God, the more you can see Him. The more you read the Word of God, the more you can see God. This world try to make you think that God does not exist. But when you understand that God made the heavens, He made the earth and everything getting, and that He made man in His image and of His likeness, when you go outside, all of a sudden, you have an understanding that God is all around us, because everything that we see in this world, God created it. But the enemy want to make you think that there's no good in this world. And that's a lie. There is good in the world, but you got to look for it. But the enemy try to blind you so that you can see nothing positive in your life. That's why you got to seek Jesus every day of your life so that you can see the things that God wants you to see. You got to be able to see yourself in the future. And you got to run for it. You got to give yourself a vision so that you can run for something. Because without no vision, the people perish. But you got to know that there's a promised land on the other side of what we're going through today. And this is only a season. This is a season that the people need to repent and turn from their wicked ways, humble themselves, pray, seek the Lord, and He will give the instructions. Then He will heal the land. He will give you what we are supposed to do. He will give you the information that we need to come out of this. But you have to seek the Lord. You have to humble yourself. So many people want to be served instead of learning how to serve. So many people want to be served instead of learning how to serve. Did I say that right? Holy Ghost. People think that being served is a sign of I'm great. Look at all the people serving me. Look at all the people following me. Look at all the people that look up to me. Look at all the people. Look. People always want people to look at me. When our job is to humble ourselves like the Lord Jesus Christ, when His disciples, before He was crucified, after the Lord's Supper, He humbled Himself and He started washing the feet of the disciples. He started washing the feet of the disciples. Now, you need to know, back in them days, the slave, the servant, was the ones that washed off the master's feet, because they had to walk outside. It was dung. It was manure. That's what dung is, manure. Amen. Dirt, filth, nasty. And they didn't want to bring what was outside inside the house. So the slave's job was to wash the master's feet. But Jesus gave us an example on how to serve. And even though He was the Lord of lords and the King of kings, He humbled Himself and He washed the feet of the disciples to show that we have to humble ourselves. Even the higher people raise us up. Even the higher God raises up. When He's raising you up, the lower you should go, to the point where you're washing the feet of the people that's following you. God wants us to seek His face. He wants us to be more like Him instead of being more like the world or more like the devil. The way up is down. Hallelujah. Let me say that again. The way for success is not up, it's down. If you want to go up, you got to go down. Because if anybody thinks he's great or she's great or want to be great, he say, humble yourself and let that person become servant of all. We need to learn how to be more servants than trying to be somebody great. Learn how to be a servant and God will make you great. Hallelujah. Turn with me to Proverbs. Turn with me to Proverbs. And we're going to turn to Proverbs 8. Proverbs 8, verse 17. Proverbs 8, verse 17. I'm going to read it in the King James Version. And then I'm also going to read it in the NLT Version. Amen. Hallelujah. Proverbs 8, verse 17. It says, I love them that love me. I love them that love me. And those that seek me early shall find me. Watch this. Riches and honor are with me. Yea, durable riches and righteousness. My fruit is better than gold, yea, than fine gold. And my revenue than choice silver. I lead in the way of righteousness in the midst of the path of judgment, that I may cause those that love me to inherit substance. And I will fill their treasures. Oh, Lord, thank you, Jesus. And he say, I will lead in the way of righteousness in the midst of the path of judgment that I may cause those that love me, those that love me to inherit substance. And I will fill their treasures. In the NLT version, it says this, the NLT version, the New Living Translation, it says, I love all who love me. Those who search will surely find me. I have riches and honor. I have riches and honor, as well as enduring wealth and justice. My gifts are better than gold, even the purest gold. My wages better than sterling silver. I walk in righteousness in the path of justice. Those who love me inherit wealth. I will fill their treasures. God saying, you got to get up early and look for him. Why do we get up early? Because we don't want to be disturbed when we're coming into the presence of God. God wants us to be in that secret place, that place where you can hear from God. Because the enemy will bring distractions when you're trying to communicate with God. But God want to have an intimate relationship with you. God want to be connected to you. God want you to be so close with him to where you can hear his voice at all times and you can talk to him all day. That's why the Bible talk about the pray without ceasing. That's you talking to God throughout the day. You can hear him in the midst of chaos. You can hear him through the good times. You can hear him through the bad times. You know how to humble yourself in the presence of God so that you can hear his voice so he can give you instructions. So he said, and those that seek me early shall find me. And when you find that good place with the Lord, he say, riches and honor are with me. Yea, durable riches and righteousness. God want to bless his children. But we have to be obedient to the word of God. We have to be obedient to the things of God. We have to want to be successful in Christ than rather being successful in the world. Because the world can make you successful, but the world will take it away. But when God bless you and raise you up for his glory, ain't no man going to be able to snatch what God has given you out of your hands. As long as you humble yourself, pray, turn from your wicked ways. And when you get blessed, don't decide to go back into sin and mess up everything, because God will blow on everything that he has given you. Because God is a jealous God. He don't want you loving him for a minute, and then all of a sudden you get everything God has, and then you turn back to sin so you can show off and show that I'm the boss, I'm the one that got this, and that's why I'm the one that got that. You know how people brag all the time about what they have, and all of a sudden God blows on it, and all of a sudden the one that was glorying is all of a sudden the one without nothing. I'd rather have nothing in the kingdom of God than to be something in the world. Because I know in the world is temporary. But what God has for us is forever. Forever. God want to bless his children right here on this earth. People are always talking about when I get to heaven, I live in a mansion. We have a city that's transparent like gold. We have streets paved in gold. And people think that being blessed is when we get to heaven, when God is wanting his children to be blessed right here on this earth. Don't you know you can have a little bit of heaven right now on this earth? Who can win most souls for the Lord? The poor man or the rich man? I say the rich man, because everybody want to be like him. Everybody want what he have. And God is the one that bless. He the one that blesses men and women with riches, with wealth, and everything. Why? So that we can win souls for the glory of God. You can draw more people when you're successful. Why people don't come to church now is because the church is not as successful as it should be. The people have determined in their mind, have made up in their mind, I don't need all of that. But yet you're trying to get your kids to come to church, but they don't want to come to church because they see you still living in sin. They see you not being blessed, but yet you say you're talking tongues, but you're just bubbling and a little shandling. But God wants you to really serve him so that he can bless you. He want to bless you while you're here on this earth. He want to bless you with good health. He want to bless you in your finances. He want to bless your family. He want to bless you that you prosper. Why? Because you can win souls for the Lord when you are the light of the world. But we got people looking at the world and what the devil has. Oh, look what they got. Look what he got. Look around. You see the house he got? You got that? Everybody talking about robbing and stealing and got the bling bling and the cards and all this stuff. And they drawing our young people to the streets and to the devil because of the things they see. But the church is supposed to be the ones that's rich. The church should be the one that's blessed. The church, the body of Christ, should be the head and not the tail, above and not beneath. But the enemy makes it appear that God is not blessing his children. And the reason God don't bless his children, because his children is not following the instructions. You have to follow the instructions of the manual. You got to get the Bible and you got to read the manual. This Bible is your inheritance. God tells you how to get the money. God tells you how to get good health. God tells you how to be successful. God is the one that want to bless you for the rest of your life. But you got to humble yourself and you got to turn from your wicked ways. And then shall we hear from heaven. And he will heal our land. But you got to want to serve him. And humble yourself in his presence. And God will exalt you in due time. Watch this. This is my last scripture. In Isaiah chapter 55. And we're going to pick it up at verse 6. It says this. Seek ye the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts. And let him turn, and let him return unto the Lord, and he will have mercy upon him, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, saith the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. In the NLT version, it says this: seek the Lord while you can find him. Call on him now while he is near. Let the wicked change their ways and banish the very thought of doing wrong. Get rid of your thoughts of doing wrong. Let them turn to the Lord that he may have mercy on them. Yes, turn to God, for he will forgive generously. My thoughts are nothing like your thoughts, says the Lord. And my ways are far beyond anything you could imagine. For just as the heavens are higher than the earth, so my ways are higher than your ways, and my thoughts higher than your thoughts. Lord Jesus. See, the word of God is preached by itself. Seek the Lord while you can find him. People, children of God, right now, our time is running out. We need to seek the Lord while he can be found. Because the Lord is sure to return. He is coming back. And the Bible says when he come back, he gonna come back as a thief in the night. When you least expect it, bam, he gonna come back. The question is, will he find you being about his father's business, or will he find you in sin? I don't play around with God because I love God too much. I serve him because he have done too much for me. I trust him because every time I was lost and in trouble, he was the one that delivered me out of all my sins. The Bible says this poor man cried and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamped around about them that fear him and delivered them. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. God is good to us saints. If you humble yourself, cry out to him, he will come and he will heal our land. But we got to turn from our wicked ways, because God is not playing around during this season. If you don't love him and if you don't trust him, you might as well make preparation, because you are not going to make it. But the people that choose to come to God and to serve God with their whole heart, God will deliver them out of all their sins and he shall heal the land. Either you're going to be the children of Israel that inherited the promised land, or you're going to be a part of that generation that died because of their complaint and their unbelief. God is not playing, because he's soon to return. Jesus is soon to return. And he wants his children to be found serving him, being obedient to him. Serving him with your whole heart. Not trying to be liked in man's eyes, but be pleasing in the sight of God's eyes. Do what's right in the sight of the Lord. Humble yourselves in the presence of God Almighty, and he will heal our land. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I give you all the praise and all the glory. I thank you, Lord Jesus, for what you have spoken through my lips. Lord, I humble myself in your presence, and I pray that the words penetrate the heart of your people, that they have a greater desire to want to serve you all the days of their life. Lord, give them ears to hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying. Because this world is in trouble, and this world needs you more than ever, Heavenly Father. We are calling on you right now in the name of Jesus to come and heal our land. We don't know how many more people will die because of this virus, but Lord, I pray that you bless the house of the saints of God. That you bless us, Lord. Keep us, protect us, bless our children, keep our children, protect our children, protect our households, Heavenly Father. Draw your people closer to you in the name of Jesus. For we know that one day soon you shall return. Heavenly Father, we cast in all of our cares upon you because we know that you care about us. Lord, we're trusting in you. And we're leaning not to our own understanding, but in all thy ways, we're going to acknowledge you. And we believe in by faith that you shall direct our path. And Heavenly Father, for those who can be in sin right now, in the name of Jesus, for anybody that can be in sin right now, the Lord Jesus Christ is knocking at the door of your heart. He wants to come into your heart. He want to come into your life, and he want to fellowship with you, because God has a plan for your life, my brother and my sister. God don't care about what you have done in the past. God's concerned whether you are saved and living for him. God wants his children to be saved. Because he didn't make hell for his children. He made hell for the devil and his demons. But a lot of us has been tricked by the enemy. But God understands. And he still loves you. And he still have a plan for your life. But you got to repent of your sins and turn from your wicked ways. And the Lord will heal this land. Romans 10 and 9 say, if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised Jesus from the dead, the Bible says you shall be saved. Can you say, Lord Jesus? Can you say, Lord Jesus? Repeat after me. Lord Jesus, forgive me for all of my sins. I do believe that you died on the cross and was buried. And on the third day, God the Father raised you from the dead. And right now, Lord Jesus, I open the doors to my heart and I receive you into my heart as my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen, amen. Well, saints of God, I want to thank you for tuning in to our broadcast once again. If you like to give and start the year off right, amen, we want to give you an opportunity to sow a seed, amen. God told us to give, and it shall be given unto us. A good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over shall men give into your bosom. But the first part of that verse, he told us to give. So if you like to pay your tithes and your offerings, I want to invite you to go to our website, askforgospel.org, askforgospel.org. Look for the donation button. You also can pay your tithes and give your offerings on Giveify. You also can pay your tithes and offerings on the Cash App. Amen, the Cash App. Look for Ask for Gospel Oakland. Ask for Gospel Oakland, amen, on the Cash App, and you can start the year off right, amen. I want to thank you once again for tuning in to our broadcast. Remember that we love you, and there's not a thing you can do about it. God bless you all.